the correct order of your skincare routine? This is something that confuses so many, so let's figure it out together. Hi, my name is Juraj and I'm the skincare stan. Thank you so much for joining me today and let's get into it. The first main rule when it comes to applying your skincare correctly is cleansing first, sunscreen last. For everything in between cleansing and sunscreen, you're going to follow another rule. Thinnest to thickest, which means first you apply your thinner consistency serums and products, and then you go into your thicker consistency serum and products, moisturizers, oils, etc. So, in a double cleanse, we always start with a balm or an oil. Both of these products are oil-based, which means they're going to help remove all of the oil-based stuff off of your face. That means your makeup, your waterproof SPF, and maybe even some excess sebum that your face has created throughout the day. The second step of a double cleanse is always going to be a water-based cleanser. A water-based gel is going to make sure you're going to remove any leftover oils or any leftover dirt that was left after the first oil cleanse. I find that using this method really gets my skin cleaned up and ready for the rest of my routine. In your morning routine, I don't think a double cleanse is necessary. You can only use your water-based cleanser and just move on with the rest of your routine. So the second step is always going to be your eye creams or your eye-related products. This is going to make sure that the actives from these eye creams really penetrate your skin the best. This is an area where we often need most help, and these products are quite costly, so you want to make sure everything that you put there is easily absorbed. This is why we put them so early on. After your eye cream, you're gonna wanna use your toner or your essence. There are a couple rules here though. If you're using a toner that has strong actives, something like salicylic acid, you might wanna use it every other day or so. Also, you wanna use this on dry skin because you don't want these actives to penetrate too deeply into your skin and cause irritation. However, if you're using something like a hydrating toner, you can use it on damp skin and you can definitely use this once or twice a day. Then we enter serums, my favorite step. And when it comes to serums, once again, we have a set of different rules depending on the kind of product that you're using. If you are using a serum with some really strong active ingredients, such as retinol or an exfoliating serum, you're going to want to make sure you're not causing any irritation. And you can do this by always applying the serum on dry skin. Also, if you're using a vitamin C serum, this is also recommended. However, if you're using a hydrating serum or a serum with hyaluronic acid or a serum with peptides, for example, these are the kind of serums that you can freely and you are encouraged to actually apply onto damp, wet skin. This way, those serums are really going to bind to that water and keep it locked in, so your skin has more moisture throughout the day or throughout the night. I don't recommend mixing together too many serums all at once, especially if they have strong active ingredients. I recommend maybe using one hydrating serum and one serum with a strong active, and that being it. However, I know there are people who like to apply 3, 4 or more serums, and in that case, you're going to want to apply thinnest to thickest. However, avoid applying the ones with strong active ingredients onto wet face. So it can get a little bit tricky. However, if you follow these ground rules, you're going to figure out a way to get that job done. After your serum step, this is where you're going to want to incorporate your retinols, or if you're using tretinoin. However, make sure to not mix these with some other strong actives in your previous steps, and also always make sure to apply your retinol or tretinoin onto dry skin. If you want to avoid irritation, if you have really sensitive skin, you can also apply your retinol or tretinoin after your moisturizer. However, if you have skin that isn't very sensitive, this is going to be the correct placement for your favorite retinol serum. And the next step is the moisturizer, one of the most important steps. This is going to make sure that all of the goodies, all of the hydration, all of the actives, everything that you just put on your skin is going to be locked in and not going to evaporate in the air. So please use a moisturizer even if you have oily skin. There are great moisturizers out there that are even formulated for oily skin and that are not going to be too heavy on your skin. So please don't give up on a moisturizer. A moisturizer is key to healthy and glowing skin. After a moisturizer is where I like to include my spot treatment. So if you have any products that are really for fighting pimples or for drying them out, this is the place where you should put them into your routine. You can also place them before a moisturizer. However, I figured out that sometimes when I put it on before a moisturizer, the product spreads all over the face instead of it being a spot treatment like it was formulated to be. So in the end, I figured it's the best to use it after a moisturizer. After your spot treatments come face oils. If you have really dry skin, face oils are a great way to really help lock in all of that moisture. Even if you've used a moisturizer, sometimes, especially during winter days, it's not enough for dry skin people. So this is a great way to keep that moisture locked in. It always comes last before SPF because oils really create that barrier on your skin, and whatever you put on top of it is not going to penetrate your skin as much. So this is why we put oils always in the last steps of our skincare routine. And the final step is always going to be sunscreens. Well, at least in the morning. Obviously, we're not going to apply sunscreen in the evening. However, this is an unskippable step, something that is of profound importance when it comes to skincare. And I want you to always apply this last in your skincare routine because we want to create this barrier of sunscreen on top of all of your other products that is going to keep your skin protected from the sun and those nasty UVA and UVB rays throughout the day. And this is it. In my personal opinion, this is the perfect arrangement to apply your skincare products. Of course, there is a lot of steps in here. Even I, a skincare fan, don't do all of these steps all of the times. So, what are the most important steps from this entire list that if you're only beginning skincare and you want to simplify your routine, what are the most important steps? Well, there are only three mandatory steps. I would say cleansing, moisturizer, and your sunscreen are the three must-haves. No matter who you are, no matter if you're into skincare, you need those three steps in your routine because they are necessary and they're going to keep your skin healthy and protected. Everything else is extra, but it can be good. Like, some of us want those extra hydration benefits. Some of us wanna get a little bit of an anti-aging boost. So, you know, choose what you need and apply it correctly. I believe that good skincare is all about knowledge, and if you apply your skincare ingredients correctly and if you figure out what works for you, you're going to have healthy, happy, glowing skin in no time. And remember that healthy skin isn't always skin that looks perfect. Healthy skin is skin that is working for you. Healthy skin is a progress. So if you are on your acne journey and if you are right now breaking out or you are changing different kind of actives and trying to find out what works for you, don't worry about it too much. You're gonna find what works for you. Just keep being educated, stay positive, and remember acne doesn't define you. You are an acne warrior and you can get through this. See you in the next video. Bye bye.